Hello and welcome to the show. We are here today on Forza Horizon 3 for some cross-country races in A-class heavyweight vehicles. You see, I tend not to use the cross-country races too much in previous events, so I decided to make an entire session about them. And we are going to be using some cars that weigh over 4,000 pounds. Some, like this Gurkha, for example, weigh a lot more than 4,000 pounds. Other cars, a little bit closer to the weight limit. Actually, a really interesting mix of cars. We've got an Impala, Gurkha, LM002, Range Rover, Chrysler, Cadillac, Ford Falcon is in here. We've got the old muscle car. We've got an El Camino down here. There's a Ferrari. Cyclone Jeep Wrangler, and then we have me over here with the mighty Wagoneer. Hopefully it'll be able to hold its worth. The real tough part in many ways with this challenge when it comes to building a car for this is in A-class, do you go for rally tyres or not? If you don't have rally tyres, you can get a lot of power. If you do have rally tyres, you're perhaps going to be underpowered for the straight bits. Now that's why I have gone for a Wagoneer. I've got the V10 engine in it, so over 700 horsepower. Are we going to... There we go. You're actually going to let me click on the button eventually. We've got over 700 horsepower and still full-width rally tyres in an all-wheel drive car. So, I'm hoping it's going to be quick, but it does also have a tendency to fall over, which is, yeah, something to worry about. Right, it is now daytime as we are going to tackle the Waters Way cross-country. This, I have driven this circuit once before. It was with the crazy Renault Clio that, was it a B-class something or others? I had a absolutely absurdly fast Williams Clio, although it didn't like the water. Now I am hoping that the Jeep might be a little bit happier. The gear ratios are not great for getting started though, apparently. Oh, gotta be careful of the rocks. Oh, nearly ended up in the side of a Land Rover. Now the Gurkha, oh, there's a little bit of lag going on, and Land Rover and Gurkha are having a fight. Gotta try and get across, make sure that I do get to the checkpoint. Yeah, we do not want to have an argument. Oh, Cyclone's gone. Cyclone's in the trees. Oh, I can't see. I'm taking all of the forest with me. The forest is coming on an adventure with a Jeep Wagoneer. That Gurkha is surprisingly menacing in the rearview mirror. It has got no speed, but look at it go through the corners. Straight line speed is god awful, but through the turns, it is mighty. We're taking in all sorts of wonkier line through there. The Wagoneer is up into fourth place. The Ferrari is leading the way. The Impala's up in third. The Lamborghini, well, we did expect the Lamborghini might be pretty damn fast. It's a very, very powerful one, but I don't think it's on rally tyres. Oh, the Ferrari's gone for a spin when it came to the water. This is where the Gurkha's going to come soaring past. Look at it go. Admittedly, I was a little bit slowed down by having to try and avoid traffic. The Gurkha just got an incredible run. The Gurkha's in the lead, and I wasn't expecting to be saying that at any point in this video, but it might not have been such a stupid choice after all, because it's, well, it kind of crushes the terrain out of the way. It doesn't really have to worry about dealing with the terrain. The terrain has to worry about fighting a Gurkha, not the other way around. Oh, now we come plummeting down the hill. There was a Lamborghini LM002 somewhere around. I'm not quite sure where. Gurkha is absolutely flying out here. Oh, that's a big sideways moment over a bump, and I am pointing the wrong way. We have saved it. We have saved it, and we are miles clear of the rest of the field that's all missed checkpoints and so on. However, we have got a Gurkha leading by an absolute mile. I am still slightly in shock, I'm going to be honest. The Jeep is proving to be a pretty solid choice of car. I'm liking it so far. A small driving error by me. I bet the Ferrari doesn't like going into this water anywhere near as much as I do in the Wagoneer, or as much as the Gurkha. I suspect the water doesn't even slow the Gurkha down. Well, a second place. Normally I would say that's not too bad a start, but the fact that I got beaten by a Gurkha by some... some 11 seconds is a turn up for the books. A real turn up for the books. So for our next race, we are heading to the beach around the sort of ship graveyard area. Oh, I'm starting from pole. That means things can only go spectacularly well, slash wrong, slash upside down. Upside down is quite likely here because this circuit has got plenty of jumps to be worrying about. Oh, we've got slow starting thing on an uphill. It's not so good starting on a hill. It's not so good starting on a hill. Never mind. We are there. Oh, hello, Land Rover. Careful now. Make sure that we get into the checkpoint. There goes Bentley, in fact. Oh, Bentley's about to do a front flip. Caught that out of the side. Had to kind of focus on getting my vehicle back across in time. We've got something going up the inside. I can't really see. It doesn't look like an SUV. Hey, there goes the Gurkha. The Gurkha's up into the lead. Now, I'm not sure whether this truck is going to suit the Gurkha or not. Oh, it's very busy and I'm in the middle of everything. We're in the middle of a four wide at the moment, and that's never a good thing. Right, Gurkha leads, Wrangler in second, Mercedes up in third. I'm in fourth with a Land Rover in fifth. Oh, that'll be an aerial overtaken. Say aerial overtaken. That was just a straight up landing. We've just been landed on by the, whatever it was, Land Rover, that's the thing. Anyway, we've distracted. Oh, Christ, we hit a bump really awkwardly and that just tipped my Jeep sideways. Oh, we're still struggling actually with some of these sort of medium speed corners. I think it's the suspension doing funky things, causing issues with the Jeep. Into the water we go. The Mercedes is bouncing off of bits of scenery and very nearly spun and very nearly got eaten by my Jeep. The Wrangler is trying to put up a fight against a Gurkha. There's only so much you could apparently do. Surprisingly, the Gurkha is a fantastic vehicle. I wondered if it might come unstuck around what is a much, much tighter circuit here. But no, tighter circuits are what the Gurkha excels at, apparently. I don't know how this makes sense. The Gurkha gets a crazy, crazy, crazy engine going on in it, hence why it can be, well, apparently doing this when it weighs about the same as a small moon, because that's ridiculous. It is buggered off. I mean, the Wrangler, I'm not too surprised at, has probably got more power than I do, and is a tiny, tiny little vehicle. I would say is light. It's probably one of the lighter, certainly the SUVs here, but it's still going to be got to be above 4,000 pounds. The Gurkha has just gone. The Gurkha has just completely and utterly buggered off. Now, there is a cheeky way to gain some time if you try and avoid the jump. By keeping all of the wheels on the ground, you have more time accelerating forward. Oh, and I think the Gurkha missed a checkpoint. The Gurkha was trying to be clever and just it has cost him dearly as he has been dropped back. Well, he's been dropped back to third. I guess not quite as dearly as it could have done in the long run. Oh, don't run too wide. Don't end up in a ship. That's never a good place to end up in. Oh, God, my Jeep is having massive issues. I'm going to roll. Come on, land it. Go. That suspension is bouncy, and that is causing big problems here. It's not a missed checkpoint that's got me. No, we're just bounced our way along the deck of a ship. As you, there are weird things being said in this race, okay? That's kind of just what's going to happen, really, I suspect. Now, what can we do about the Mercedes again? A podium would be not too... If we can get all podiums, I would be perfectly okay with that one. Both me and the Mercedes opting for the avoiding of the jump technique. I can't do anything at this moment in time. We're just going to hound the back of that Mercedes. No, we're not going to be able to get through there. I can probably turn tighter than he can on the sand. Oh, through the air we go with a crash. Mercedes is still there on the outside. A little bit of a bump. I'll make sure that I do get these checkpoints. And this is costing me any chance of going after the Gurkha. Although, to be fair, as I say that, I think the Gurkha's probably got me here. So, yeah, we've got to keep it dead straight on the way across that ship. Because it just bounces so awkwardly around there. Now, passing the Mercedes, where are we going to be able to do it? We have got good corner speed. We've just got to kind of end up or try and not get compromised by the Mercedes. Yeah, we can take so much more speed around these turns. Mercedes might be a little bit quicker on the acceleration front, but has got nothing. I imagine the Mercedes is probably not running dirt tyres. I don't think it would fit in the PI with dirt tyres. Oh, no. That's the risk you run if you go for the avoiding the jump method. You just mistime it and you clip some of the metal. You will have all sorts of trouble. Thankfully, didn't roll it across. If you hit kind of the corner of the ramp, very easy for it to act as a split ramp and for you to end up in a lot of strife. That did not quite happen. Still, it is the Jeep leading the way. Doesn't look like though for too much longer, despite a missed checkpoint. That Gurkha is silly, silly fast. We are on the tail of the Mercedes. In fact, I think we've jumped over the Mercedes, or the Mercedes may have missed a checkpoint. No, he got it. Well played. Well played. He was twisting the car on takeoff to try and make sure to get the or to get a quick line through that checkpoint. Is kind of working for him. He's holding me off for now as we dive up the inside into turn one. This is a great battle for third. I am glad that I am racing in this battle for third rather than circulating on my own at some point around this track. I am not risking it this time around. I think I've got the better car overall, so I'm not going to risk it. We have moved ahead of the Mercedes. I spy a green Jeep ahead of me. Don't know whether we had a spin, missed a checkpoint. I got a huge sideways moment that's cost me a bunch of time. Mercedes is coming up on my outside pot somewhere. I think I can just about see a Mercedes in the rearview mirror. Go away. Go away, names. I don't want to know. I don't really care. I need to be able to see the rearview. I hate the suspension on this Jeep at the moment. It is just getting tipped by everything around the course. However, we have landed safely on this final time. There is the Wrangler. He's had a very, very bad lap. Whatever happened to him, I am going to pull clear of the Mercedes. It is going to be two podiums out of two. A second and a third. However, no match. Gurkha is so bloody fast, and a slightly awkward roll off the boat would prevent me from making the most of the Wrangler's later mistake. The Impala would come home in fifth ahead of the Range Rover in sixth, potentially, at least. We'll have to wait and see. No, they didn't even make it. That's how far ahead the Gurkha was. Turns out it is a damn good choice for a racing vehicle. Who knew? It is off to the outback for our next race, the Redstone Strip Cross Country. This, if I remember the circuit right, I think loops around and bounces its way through the dunes a little bit. Might get the Gurkha stuck. In fact, the Gurkha gets bloody pole. Typical. In fact, we've got all the SUVs at the front of this one. In fact, one Wagoneer is further down. Like, kind of cyclone, but yeah, all of the giant vehicles start off at the front here. This might cause the Gurkha issues. Its lack of straight line speed may become quite evident out here. As, we sweep our way through these opening corners. It is the Land Rover that will lead the way. I suspect the Wrangler will be pretty damn fast around here. I'll be honest, got to watch out for some AI cross traffic. That could cause issues. I'd also expect the Lamborghini to be pretty rapid. Oh, there's the other Wagoneer. The Wagoneer's shot through the corner. And oh, there's a Gurkha. Found it. Or it found me. Not sure which way around that lot was. We're on a really tight line there. That's no good. A little bit of leaning going on, but I'm fine with that. It's kind of benefited me in all of that corner. Come on. We can outdrag the Gurkha. And I would expect to be able to say, that's the only sentence that's made sense tonight, I think. We can outdrag the Gurkha. See, I'm trying to get away with chucking my car in and carrying the speed. I just don't. We've got a bit of assistance from everything. The Land Rover is mega fast in a straight line. And there comes everything else. There's a lot of speed going on. Also, I do apologise. I might have lied a little bit about my car's power. I thought it had 700. It's actually got 650. It's not quite as powerful as I expected it to be. That might explain a little bit why we are perhaps struggling in places. If some of these vehicles here don't have rally tyres on, they could well have a lot more power than me. So yeah, that would explain things. Although then when we come through the corners, come through the dunes, this is where the Wrangler will make up some time, but the Gurkha will make up time on all of us if the Wrangler doesn't fall over. Oh, Wrangler's fallen over, and the Wagoneer, sorry, not Wrangler. I know my cars. We've fallen over and stalled it a little bit. It's fine, only minor problems. We're going for spectacular jump across the plain into a tree. I don't know what's happened to the Gurkha. It might have missed a checkpoint and had to reset. That will put it a long way down, in fact, here. We can't do anything. Well, maybe we can. Do we get our foot down? No, we don't have the grip. We're in the same car. We've probably got same size dirt tires. Oh, make the checkpoint. There we go. We've got it, but we are very nearly out of time here. It is whether we have the grip, the acceleration to get past the Impala. We will not. We're going to have to settle for a sixth place. Disappointing. Hey, we've got a roll across, or a roll after the line, in fact. Ah, disappointing. Disappointing race from me. Should have kept up my podium spree, or certainly should have been fighting for it. An unfortunate bounce and a rollover. It would be the Wrangler that would take a victory. The Mercedes, a great showing from the Mercedes up in second. Range Rover in third, head of the Lamborghini Impala, my Wagoneer. Chrysler 300 would beat the other Wagoneer, the Gurkha, down in ninth place. Jaguar XJS and a Cyclone to round out the race. Much like at Blizzard Mountain, where we always have to finish off with a trip to the snow park, if I'm doing cross-country races on the mainland, I can't resist going to the rainforest circuit. This is a fantastically chaotic place to race cars. It has produced some absolutely fantastic racing. I fear it is going to be Gurkha Central. My brain is still struggling slightly to adjust to that. However, I do feel like this could be a very, very strong track for the Gurkha, as it's relatively short, lots of corners for that car, truck, tank, whatever you want to call it, to take a lot of speed through. We will have to wait and see as we crest the humongous jump. There's a Mercedes in the wing mirror doing all sorts of interesting angles across there. The opening section is probably going to be too good for the Gurkha. This sort of corner down there is where it can really, really excel. Now, we're flowing through the air. We've actually landed underneath a Ford. We've lifted the Ford up as we came out of that river, which is quite impressive, really. I apologise to the Ford. We kind of jumped through the air, and there was no control and nothing that I could do about avoiding that one. The Wagoneer at the front is absolutely buggering off around here. We're going to the inside into turn one. We will get past the Raptor. Could we get a 1-2 for the Wagoneers? That might be asking a little bit too much. We'll have to wait and see. I have massive concerns about the bouncy suspension going on in this Jeep, if I'm honest. However, because again, the back end is kind of controlling the car for me, which is not a sentence you want to be saying, although we're making ground. We are making ground on the leader, and as I say that, we're going to go up for a spin. It's just so uncontrollable. Oops, that might be my bad, slightly. in all of that one, it is so uncontrollable when it just starts going. There is nothing I can really do to bring it back to order. Try and carry speed. The only thing they have going for me is the leader might be having as many problems as I am. Does depend on how the vehicle is built. I believe this one has rally suspension. I'm pretty sure I put rally suspension on the car, so I don't know why we're struggling so much with it. Oh, come on now. There we go. We've made it through there just about. Bloody hell. I can't believe I'm saying this. However, the Gurkha, when I was following it, looks so much nicer and a lot more planted through these corners. Oh, come on. Come on. We can make it. There we go. Right, 5 seconds. We have not got very much race to go to make up 5 seconds. Apparently, though, this is a really Wagoneer-friendly circuit, because we are dropping the rest of the field. We had a Land Rover right behind us in a lap. We have buggered off. We have absolutely buggered off. We seem to be also setting identical... There we go. Just say, surely we couldn't still be setting identical sectors, because the gap hadn't changed for about 3 passes through. We are catching the leader. Leader probably had a big, scary suspension wobble moment at some point. Well, if we can keep catching at this rate, we might get him on the final lap. We'll be close enough at the final lap to have a go. Oh, come on, Wagoneer. Do not fail me now. I have always been a big fan of the Wagoneers, in fact, in Forza games, since the autocross. Since it proved its magic ability at autocrossing. Can it be... Well, can I get a result out of it once more? Admittedly, we are against other Jeeps. It's less surprising to see Wagoneers at the front of this race. We are absolutely flying at this moment in time. I fear, though, if I push this too hard, we're going to have an accident, or we're going to have a spin or a roll. The Wrangler is up into third, I think. I daren't even think about having a look around because there is one lap to go. We are just half a second behind, and it's going to close to practically nothing as we run up towards the start-finish line. Can we make the pass stick into turn one? I think we might be able to. Didn't want to end up missing that checkpoint, so we kind of backed out of it a little bit. Someone up ahead is struggling quite a lot. I think that's the Chrysler 300C. Yeah, this circuit perhaps not so good for the Chrysler. We've got a bit of massive aerial attack on him. Don't know where he ended up. He is still ahead of me, and he will get the checkpoint. Bugger and blast. The aerial attack might have cost me in this one, because I don't think I'm going to get another choice. We're going to have to throw it up the inside of the Chrysler, and I can't do it. I threw everything at it. I threw absolutely everything at it, and we are going to lose the second place. Bugger. I mean, I had to do it, really. we might lose more if we're not careful. We're bouncing off the road. I think that wagon at the... Right, Wrangler, sorry, there's too many cars with similar names. I think the Wrangler may well be the fastest of the lot of us, but got stuck in traffic early on. Indeed he is, that lap time wise. The Wrangler is mighty quick, as is the Gurkha once more. However, it is a 1-2-3 for the Jeeps. I couldn't quite do it. I gave it everything that I could. However, a wonky takeoff would see me sort of land on the roof of my fellow Jeep and cost me a chance and a victory, and then a spin across a bump would drop me down to third. Impala coming home, a good showing from the Impala actually up in fourth. It's the only non-SUV that's really done anything half decent in this race. So, yeah. Exciting as ever at this rainforest track. Good fun racing these kind of vehicles. I am astounded still at how quick the Gurkha is. Apparently that is a stupidly fast cross-countrying A-class vehicle. The Jeeps, fairly solid choices as well, although the suspension on my Wagoneer is absolutely useless. However, that is going to be it from me. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, goodbye.